Assalamu alaikum everybody, this is Farah Riaz from Bagh School Arts and Design Department. Today I will be sharing some information regarding paints. As you know that whenever we talk about arts or an artist, the first thing that comes to one's mind is that if it is an artist, he or she must be a painter. So paints has basically become the identification of arts. Even though arts is a very, very, very vast subject and it has many things to it, many branches, many genres that you do not know as yet, but again, painting is the most important. So I will be sharing some information regarding some different paints, because there are many people out there who already like painting, and this lesson hopefully will just help them choose the right paint and know what are the different paints finishes and what are their viscosities. When it comes to choosing paint, select a paint based on style and finish. There are a variety of unique paints to select from with varying methods of application and viscosities. These paint types are guaranteed to be a premier choice for your art project. With each paint supplying a unique look for you, the possibilities are endless. When we say that the possibilities are endless, we actually mean it, because supposedly if you choose a subject of your painting to be a beautiful huge flower, you have a variety of different paints to choose from to give it a whole different look. According to what paint you choose, you can create a texture, or you can create the glossiness, or you can control the mattness of your painting. Acrylic paints are extremely versatile and ideal for fine brushwork, glazing, staining, multimedia techniques, and many more. This smooth and light paint has excellent pigment quality, color strength, and durability. The acrylic paint can be applied to almost any stable surface like watercolor paper or canvas. It is quick drying and can be purchased in a variety of forms like a tube or a smalling bottle, varying in viscosity. Now, as you know that most of my students are already using acrylic paints in the class, as this is basically a water-based paint and it is less toxic. It does not have a lot of odor, which is good for a less ventilated room, even though our arts hall is one of the best. It is one of the best facility in the country. And acrylic paints are the favorites of students right now, or young artists you can say, as you have the control of just mixing water to make the consistency of the paint as you like. It can be as thick as you want and it can be as light as you want. The washing it off from brushes is also very easy. Just a little soap in your water and that just does the job. So let's see an example of acrylic paint. As you can see that acrylic is a very bright in color. You can see that each and every color pigment bright shines very, very properly in this painting. It is very easy to control. And the thing that I like the most in acrylic paints is that it always retains its strokes. In some areas, this can be a little disturbing where you don't want this to happen, but you can always create and you can sculpt with the help of acrylics, because the brush strokes, they remain and they can help you in a lot of other ways. Oil-based paint is very durable and provides a glossy looking finish. Brush strokes fill themselves into a smooth, rich varnish. Oil-based paint has long-lasting coverage and blends well with others. This paint dries slowly, which works in a painter's advantage, since the artist can develop the painting gradually, making changes to the work along the way. This type of paint is water mixable, not water based. This paint possesses elasticity and is diluted thinly when more water is added. Unlike acrylics, oil based paint, oil paints or enamel paints, these are durable and they have a glossy looking finish. Acrylics have a matte finish and oil paints have a glossy finish. And now, unlike acrylics, what I loved in acrylics is that the brush retains the strokes. In oil paint, the brush does not retain a stroke. It fills the stroke and makes it a very smooth stroke. It fills in all the areas and it gives it a very smooth and very blended look. As this paint dries slowly, again, it is unlike acrylics. In acrylics, the paint dries very, very quickly. And in oils, the paint takes a lot of time to dry as it is basically oil-based, not water-based. So this goes to the advantage of artists when they are creating an artwork and they need to make slight changes later on, or they need to blend the background or anything like that. It is very easy for them to do this. Again, oil is not a water-based paint, but it is always diluted with a liquid, which can be a thinner, it can be linseed oil, or it can be water only. Now here is an example of oil paint. Unlike acrylics, you can see that it has a very smooth and a very realistic look to it. You can see that when you talk about the hair, if I had painted this hair with an acrylic paint, the strokes that were going down would have been very, very obvious. But in oils, you have to create each and every stroke, each and every direction with your brush. It cannot be done by just a stroke only. Watercolor is a translucent paint containing pigment and a binder, typically gum arabic. The gum arabic holds the paint together and ensures the paint will not flake. The paint has color pigment suspended in water until the water dries and stains the surface. The paint brushes with fluidity and a transparency and dries fairly quickly. Now, watercolor is always called the paint for beginners, as it comes in cake forms on a palette and it is pretty easy to use. All you need to do is take a little amount more of water on your brush and apply it on the cake of watercolor. And what happens is that the pigment in the cake of watercolor, it suspends into the water, mixes into the water, and when you apply it on a piece of paper, the paper is actually stained by that pigment when that water dries. So that is why they are given the name of watercolor. It just has pigment. It is the purest form of paint. It has pigment and a binder, which is called gum arabic. It is not water-based, or it is not oil-based. Now let's see an example. As you can see in this painting, this beautiful, beautiful painting, that you can very easily identify shapes and designs and images created by just stains. As you can see, that the shadow of this window are simply just stains, which are giving you an image of the shadow. The flowers, each and every leaf is not created separately. The petals are not created separately, but the stains can just show you an image. So this is the beauty of watercolor. Gouache. Gouache is a water-soluble and opaque paint, so the white of the paper surface does not show through. It is a tad chalkier than traditional watercolor and absorbs light rather than reflects it. The paint is diluted with water but possesses a strong colored pigment. This unique paint dries darker, and a lot of it goes a long way and takes time to dry, which means it can be workable for hours or even days after application. Now, gouache is a kind of a paint which is not very commonly used in schools. It is basically mostly professionally used. It is just like watercolor. It is not a water-based paint, and it needs a lot of water to be added to be used. And it has a very chalky, it possesses a very, very chalky look or finish, and it is quite thick after applying, and it gets one, you can say that the value of the color gets a point darker when it dries up. It takes a lot of time to dry, and at times it can take more than days also after application. So this is basically mostly used for those artists who are completely, their genre is just painting, and they work on a very, very typical art piece for days and days. Gouache is basically used professionally. I will show you an example of a gouache painting. As you can see, this beautiful painting is made by gouache paints, and you can see the thickness and the brightness of the color and the chalky texture that you can see without even touching the paper. You can feel the texture, that it has a chalky texture. Encaustic. Encaustic is a wax-based paint with a strong color pigment. a versatile paint choice. Encaustic has no solvents added and is impervious to moisture. It is highly durable and best used on a firm, absorbent surface. Artists can use a heat source and metal tools to begin working with this hot liquid wax known as encaustic. Encaustic is a very interesting piece of art supplies. It is used mostly by very, very professional artists and or more versatile in their paint choices. And they have not been introduced in the art hall as yet. These are paints that come in blocks of wax and they are used with a high quality or very, very high powered hot heat source equipments, like a hot air blow dryer or like a hot metal tool, which is like a, you can call it a iron brush, which heats and you apply it on the wax and then you use it on paper. And this is mostly used by artists who love to make pieces and portray designs to create a theme. For example, let's look. As you can see there in this portrait, that it is beautifully all tiled up with different colors, and by the texture you can easily see that it has been created by not a brush at all. And this painting alone must have taken days to dry up. So this is very later on a very professional level that people start using encaustic paints. So now that you know about different paints and what are these paints used for and what are the different types and what are the different mixes, I hope this is going to be very useful for you and it will help you create beautiful paintings. In the next lesson, I will be telling you about different paint brushes. So till then, Allah Hafiz, stay safe and please take care of yourself.